Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in today's video, we are going to see what are the different problems based on op-amp depending upon the various fundamentals of op-amp like slew rate, average base current, bias current, offset current and many more parameters. So let's begin with the topic. How fast the output of an op-amp change by 10 volt if its slew rate is 0.5 volt per microsecond. In this problem, the voltage change by op-amp is given as 10 volt and slew rate is given as 0.5 volts per microsecond. Basically, slew rate is nothing but rate of change of output voltage per unit time. So first, let's write down a given data. Here, the rate of change of output voltage is given as 10 volt. Therefore, dV0 is equal to 10 volt and slew rate is given as 0.5 volt per microsecond. Basically, slew rate also gives the rate of change of output voltage, that means how fast the output of op-amp gets changed whenever there is change in the input. So basically, it gives a speed of operation of op-amp. And from that, we can also calculate frequency of op-amp. Slew rate is given by S is equals to dV0 upon dt. Here, value of dV0 and slew rate is given and we need to calculate the value of time period. Therefore, let's substitute the given values and find out the time period. So, from the calculation, we get value of time as 20 microseconds. So, this is how based on the value of slew rate and output voltage, we can calculate the time period. Now, let's move to the next problem. The statement of problem is, assume that an op-amp has IB1 is equals to 400 nanoampere and IB2 equals to 300 nanoampere. Determine the average bias current IB and offset current IS0. Now in this case, two currents, that is IB1 and IB2, are given. These two currents are nothing but the current flowing through the inverting and non-inverting terminal of the op-amp. And we need to calculate average bias current IB, which is nothing but the average of two currents flowing through the non-inverting and inverting terminal of op-amp. And the second one is offset current, that is IOS, which is nothing but the difference between the current flowing through inverting and non-inverting terminal of the op-amp. So first, let's write down a given data and find out the average bias current and offset current. The average bias current IB is equals to IB1 plus IB2 divided by 2, as it is average of current flowing through inverting and non-inverting terminal of the op-amp. So the average bias current, that is value of IB, is equals to 350 nanoampere. Now let's find out the second parameter, that is offset current IOS. The value of IOS is nothing but the algebraic difference between the current flowing through inverting and non-inverting terminal of the op-amp, that is difference between IB1 and IB2. So now when we substitute this value, we can get the offset current. So the IOS is equals to 100 nanoamperes. So in this way, if the value of current is known, then we can easily calculate the average bias current and offset current IOS by using values of IB1 and IB2. Now let's move on to the next problem. The statement of problem is, assume slew rate for 741 is 0.5 volt per microsecond. What is the maximum frequency of sine wave that can be obtained for 12 volt peak? And second is 2 volt peak. Now here they have mentioned the slew rate of IC741C is 0.5 volt per microsecond. We know that slew rate is nothing but rate of change of output voltage per unit time. That means how fast the output of op-amp get changed whenever there is a change in time period. So it can also give the frequency of operation of op-amp. So first, let's write down a given data and formula for frequency of operation of op-amp. Now here we consider first option, that is voltage equals to 12 volt peak. The frequency of operation of op-amp can be calculated by using a slew rate. So the formula for frequency is F equals to S upon 2 pi into Vm. The value of slew rate is 0.5 volt per microsecond and Vm is nothing but 12 volt. So when we solve the equation, we obtain F is equals to 6.63 kHz for voltage equals to 12 volt. Now let's consider voltage is equals to 2 volt peak. So in this case also, we are going to use the same formula, that is F equals to S upon 2 pi into Vm. But here the value of Vm is equals to 2 volt. So F equals to S upon 2 pi Vm, S is equals to 0.5 volt per microsecond and Vm is equals to 2 volt. So for voltage equals to 2 volt, we obtain frequency as 39.79 kHz. So these are the some problems which are based on the various parameters of op-amp, which includes basically a slew rate, frequency of operation, input bias current and input offset current. So by using the various formulas, we can find out the different parameters of op-amp. So I hope you understand the topic and the problems based on op-amp. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.